The Supreme Court's leaked opinion has a lot of people worried about abortion rights across the country. Kim Clark has been busy answering questions. She is a senior reproductive rights attorney at Legal Voice. It's a legal advocacy organization based out of Seattle that serves Washington, Oregon, Idaho, Alaska, and Montana.
Abortion will still be legal in Washington and Oregon because both states have state statutes that have strong protections for access to abortion in Washington and Oregon.
Both states have laws requiring insurance carriers cover abortion.
Both states also have equal rights amendments, which should provide protection for the right to abortion.
But for people in Idaho, things would be different.
Idaho has both a trigger ban that will go into effect if Roe is overturned, which would ban abortion in Idaho. But it also passed a Texas SB8 lookalike statute that enables family members to bring private causes of action against abortion providers.
That, Clark says, could force people who have the means to travel to Oregon or Washington to get care.
Abortion providers in both states are expecting a dramatic increase in patients coming from out of state in order to access care.
And that could put stress on providers in more ways than one. States banning abortion, if Roe v. Wade is overturned, could sue providers in the Northwest.
We're not under any illusion that the states that are banning abortion will stop at banning abortion just within their borders.
Who knows what changes will come?
Former Oregon Representative Jeff Barker was one of the chief co-sponsors of the 2017 bill that would become an Oregon law protecting abortion access. After seeing the Supreme Court's draft opinion, he's concerned about what other rights may be on the chopping block in the future, rights like gay marriage.
You know, we're seeing attacks on gays and trans people. You know, this is kind of they're breaking the dam open with this one, and I worry about the future.